Hello and welcome to the news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Bulfateh. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, the Supreme Commander, patronized a Martyrs' Day ceremony that was held in Sakhir Palace in the presence of the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier, His Royal Highness Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. His Majesty the King was received upon arrival by BDF Commander-in-Chief Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa, National Guard Commander Lieutenant General Sheikh Mohammed bin Isa Al Khalifa, and Interior Minister Lieutenant General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa.
في هذه اللحظات يصل الموكب السامي لحضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة عاهل البلاد المفدى القائد الأعلى حفظه الله ورعاه. ترافقه كوكبة من الخيالة إلى موقع الاحتفال في قصر الصخير العامر.
His Majesty the King then headed to the main platform and the national anthem was played.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة إن الله مع الصابرين. ولا تقولوا لمن يقتل في سبيل الله أموات بل أحياء ولكن لا تشعرون. ولنبلونكم بشيء من الخوف والجوع ونقص من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات وبشر الصابرين الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. أولئك عليهم صلوات من ربهم ورحمة وأولئك هم المهتدون. صدق الله العظيم.
Verses from the Holy Quran were recited, after which one shot was fired, followed by a minute of silence. And then another shot was fired to mark the end of the silence, after which the band played the final anthem.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة ملك مملكة البحرين المفدى حفظكم الله ورعاكم.
شرع كورت اوف كاسيشن جادج اند الفاتح اسلامك موسك امام الشيخ عدنان بن عبد الله القطان تن ديليفر ذا مارتيرز سيرمون اند سبليكيشن.
اصحاب السمو والمعالي والسعاده جنود الوطن البواسي الابطال اهالي وابناء الشهداء الابرار الاخوه والاخوات الكرام السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته. وبعد، يقول رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في بيان فضل الشهادة والشهيد: ما من عبد يموت له عند الله خير يسره أن يرجع إلى الدنيا وأن له الدنيا وما فيها إلا الشهيد لما يرى من فضل الشهادة، فإنه يسره أن يرجع إلى الدنيا فيقتل مرة أخرى. بعد شكر الله تعالى نتقدم بالشكر والتقدير والامتنان لصاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة ملك البلاد المفدى حفظه الله ورعاه، الذي خصص هذا اليوم 17 من شهر ديسمبر من كل عام يوماً للشهيد، تخليداً ووفاءً وعرفاناً بتضحيات وعطاء وبذل شهداء الوطن. فتحية إجلال وإكبار ملؤها المحبة والافتخار والكرامة والاعتزاز لكل شهداء الأبطال عبر تاريخ وطننا الغالي الحافل بالتضحيات قديماً وحديثاً منذ قيام الدولة في عهد المؤسس الأول أحمد الفاتح رحمه الله تعالى إلى يومنا هذا، الذين قدموا أرواحهم دفاعاً عن دينهم ووطنهم وذوداً عن شرفهم وحقوقهم وشرعيتهم. وفي هذه المناسبة الجليلة نرفع أكف الضراعة إلى المولى العلي القدير داعين لشهداء الأبرار ماضياً وحاضراً في مملكتنا الغالية البحرين وفي دول مجلس التعاون الخليجي وفي التحالف العربي، ولكل شهيد بالرحمة والمغفرة ودخول الجنان. ونقول: اللهم إنا نسألك بأن لك الحمد لا إله إلا أنت بديع السماوات والأرض يا ذا الجلال والإكرام يا حي يا قيوم. اللهم ارحم شهداء الوطن الأبرار واحطط عنهم الأوزار وقهم عذاب النار وأنزلهم منازل الأخيار وأدخلهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار يا عزيز يا غفار. اللهم نور مراقدهم وطيب مضاجعهم. اللهم آنس وحشتهم وارحم غربتهم. اللهم نقهم من خطاياهم كما ينقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس. اللهم افسح لهم في قبورهم واجعلها رياضا من رياض الجنة. اللهم انقلهم من ضيق اللحود والقبور إلى سعة الدور والقصور. اللهم قد ترك الشهداء أهليهم وودعوا أحبابهم وفارقوا ذويهم، اللهم فارحم دموع المحبين وتأوه المشتاقين. اللهم واجمع بينهم وبين آبائهم وأمهاتهم وأهليهم وأولادهم في جنات النعيم. اللهم آمنا في وطننا، واجعل هذا البلد آمناً مطمئناً سخاءً رخاءً وسائر بلاد المسلمين. اللهم وفق ولي أمرنا ملكنا حمد بن عيسى لما تحب وترضى. اللهم اجعله مفتاحاً للخير مغلاقاً للشر. اللهم احفظه من شر الأشرار وكيد الفجار، وأعزه وأطل في عمره وأحسن عمله. اللهم ألبسه ثوب الصحة والعافية. اللهم بارك له في أهله وأولاده وذريته. اللهم وفقه لما فيه الخير والصلاح للبلاد والعباد، وهيئ له البطانة الصالحة الناصحة يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم اجمع به الكلمة ووحد به الصف، واجعله سبباً لحقل الدماء واجتماع القلوب. اللهم اجعله إماماً للتسامح والتعايش والتآخي والتحاب، إنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم من أرادنا وبلادنا البحرين وبلاد الحرمين الشريفين وخليجنا وجيشنا ورجال أمننا وأمتنا بشر وسوء وفتنة فأشغله بنفسه، واجعل كيده في نحره، وأدر دائرة السوء عليه، وأرنا فيه عجائب قدرتك، وانصرنا على من عادانا وبغى علينا يا سميع الدعاء. اللهم إنا نستودعك وطننا وخليجنا وجنودنا البواسل المرابطين الذين يحاربون عدوك وعدوهم. اللهم احفظهم برًا وبحرًا وجوًا، وانصرهم على الطاغين الباغين المعتدين. اللهم سدد رميهم وثبت أقدامهم وأنزل سكينتك عليهم وأعدهم إلى وطنهم وأهليهم سالمين غانمين. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. نقرأ الآن سورة الفاتحة على أرواح شهدائنا الأبرار، ونسأل الله تعالى أن يجعل هذه الساعة ساعة إجابة وقبول. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
يتفضل الآن سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة ملك البلاد المفدى حفظه الله ورعاه بالتوجه إلى موقع الصرح مروراً بحرس الشرف، ويقوم جلالته حفظه الله بسقي فسيلة النخلة المزروعة بجانب الصرح والتي ترمز إلى الحياة.
His Majesty the King watered a palm tree, which is a symbol of eternal life.
Thank you.
For this occasion, His Majesty the King then delivered a statement in which he paid tribute to the martyrs who sacrificed their lives for the sake of the homeland and fell in the line of duty as they were serving the nation. His Majesty the King saluted the nation's fallen heroes ever since Bahrain was established in the era of the Founding Father, as they embodied the values of valor, courage and sacrifice, describing them as a source of pride for all Bahrainis and a shining beacon which will inspire the coming generations. His Majesty added that December 17th will remain a shining milestone for a nation proud of its heroes who sacrificed their lives in Bahrain and abroad to achieve justice and defend the homeland security and sovereignty. His Majesty also said that they symbolize sacrifice and dedication, following in the steps of founding fathers and forefathers on whose legacy the National March have been built. His Majesty said that every fallen martyr is a source of pride for us, as well as for their families and fellow soldiers. He commended loyal citizens who remained cohesive and showed sympathy and solidarity with the martyrs of duty. His Majesty the King, accompanied by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, headed to the National Action Charter Monument, where he was received by the Minister of Education, Dr. Majid bin Ali Naimi, as well as senior officers marking the occasion of Martyrs' Day. His Majesty the King affirmed the importance of this occasion and prayed Allah the Almighty to rest the martyrs' souls in eternal peace. The senior officers expressed deepest congratulations to His Majesty the King, the Supreme Commander, on the occasion of the Kingdom of Bahrain's national celebrations marking the anniversary of the establishment of the modern state of Bahrain as an Arab and Muslim country in 1783 by its founder Ahmed al-Fateh, and the anniversary of the accession to the UN as a full member, and the anniversary of His Majesty the King's accession to the throne. Upon the directives of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, the Royal Court Minister Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed Al Khalifa extends thanks and appreciation and gratitude to the royal family for their congratulations to His Majesty the King and for their attendance and participation in celebrations of the Kingdom of Bahrain on its national holidays. The celebrations are in commemoration of the founding of the Bahraini state during the reign of the founder Ahmed Al Fateh as an Arab Muslim country in 1783. and the anniversary of its joining the United Nations as a full-fledged nation and the commemoration of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa's rule. He also extended appreciation to the heads and members of all state authorities, constitutional institutions, diplomatic corps and heads of state, as well as members of municipal councils and private sector companies on their congratulations to His Majesty the King on this occasion and their attendance of national celebrations. He also extended thanks to all citizens inside and outside of the country and to the heads of national societies, heads and members of national clubs and federations, sports and national events, to the editors of local newspapers and various media, and to residents of Bahrain and to all of those who participated in these national celebrations, who expressed their sincere congratulations and abundant feelings through cables of congratulations and telephone calls. He expressed appreciation, highlighting the manifestation of pride on the National Day through celebrations, festivals and rallies, the beautiful poems and expressive articles and radio and television interviews, and all other forms of expression. He also recalled the sacrifices of the honorable martyrs of the country who sacrificed their lives in order to defend it and set an example of loyalty, appreciating everyone's interaction with the Day of the Bahraini Martyr. The official ceremony of the Martyrs' Day was held at the Royal Guard headquarters at the Bahrain Defense Force under the patronage of the National Security Advisor and Commander of the Royal Guard, Major General Zaini Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, in the presence of Commander of the Royal Guard Special Force, His Highness Lieutenant Colonel Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa. The anthem of His Highness the Commander of the Royal Guard, the Holy Quran, was recited, after which one shot was fired, followed by a minute of silence and the martyrs' dua.
سيدي، خير ما نبدأ فيه حفلنا هذا آيات من الذكر الحكيم يتلوها على مسامعكم العريف أفضل عبد الله.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ولا تحسبن الذين قتلوا في سبيل الله أمواتا بل أحياء عند ربهم يرزقون. فرحين بما آتاهم الله من فضله ويستبشرون بالذين لم يلحقوا بهم من خلفهم ألا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. يستبشرون بنعمة من الله وفضل وأن الله لا يضيع أجر المؤمنين. صدق الله العظيم.
سيدي، الآن دقيقة صمت حدادا على أرواح شهدائنا البواسل. سيدي، يتفضل الآن العميد دكتور محمد علي أبو جندل بالدعاء لأرواح الشهداء.
اللهم إنا نستعين بك ونستغفرك ونستهديك ونؤمن بك ونتوكل عليك ونثني عليك الخير كله. نشكرك اللهم ولا نكفرك ونترك من يكفرك. اللهم إياك نعبد ولك نصلي ونسجد وإليك نسعى ونحفد، نرجو رحمتك ونخشى عذابك، إن عذابك الجد بالكفار ملحق. اللهم ارحم شهداءنا الأبرار، اللهم ارحم شهداءنا الأبرار، اللهم ارحم شهداءنا الأبرار، اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم وتجاوز عنا وعنهم وأكرم نزلهم ووسع مدخلهم واغسلهم بالماء والثلج والبرد ونقهم من الذنوب والخطايا كما ينقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس. اللهم وارحمنا إذا صرنا إلى ما صاروا إليه. اللهم ابدلهم دارا خيرا من دارهم وأهلا خيرا من أهلهم وزوجا خيرا من زوجهم. اللهم أنزل على قبورهم الضياء والنور والفسحة والسرور برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمناً مطمئناً سخاءً رخاءً وسائر بلاد المسلمين. اللهم احفظ مليكنا يا رب العالمين واحفظ ذريته وبارك في عمره وذريته برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اجعل الأمن في ربوعنا والسلامة من حظنا، وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين.
حرس جنبال لا
His Highness the National Security Advisor then watered a palm tree as a symbolic gesture for life, followed by a speech.
والآن يتفضل سيدي سمو اللواء الركن الشيخ ناصر بن حمد آل خليفة مستشار الأمن الوطني قائد الحرس الملكي
بإلقاء كلمته.
ولا تحسبن الذين قتلوا في سبيل الله أمواتا بل أحياء عند ربهم يرزقون. صدق الله العظيم. أخواني وأخواتي منتسبي قوة الدفاع، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. في هذا اليوم المبارك نستذكر فيه أرواح شهدائنا الأبرار الذين قدموا أرواحهم فداء لهذا البلد، الذين قاموا بجهد لا يضاحى فيه أي جهد آخر ولا شخص آخر محب لهذا الوطن يستطيع أن يوازي ما قاموا به. نعمل جاهدين ليلاً نهاراً، نقدم كل ما نستطيع إليه من قوة وطاقة، ولكن شهدائنا قدموا أرواحهم، وبالتالي أعتقد أن هذه أكبر تضحية لأي جندي، لأي مواطن مخلص لبلده. أما نحن نفتخر بهم، نستذكرهم ليلا نهارا ونتمنى مكانتهم. وفي ختام هذه الكلمة أعزز وأجدد شكري لخدمتكم ولعملكم المتواصل ولجهادكم في الدفاع عن الدين والحق، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Then His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad toured the Garden of the Martyrs in the presence of the martyrs' families, after which His Highness opened a fish farming project, the income of which will be contributing in supporting these families. Those in charge of the project affirmed that its objective is to reach a high productive capacity to support the families, and that the project contained 36 incubators and 6 containers to produce 5 to 6 tons annually. The organizers also carried out a number of scientific experiments on certain fish.
Thank you.
For his part, His Highness Sheikh Khaled said that Martyrs' Day, which is held along with National Day celebrations and the anniversary of His Majesty the King's accession to the throne, is a prominent fixture in Bahrain's history, when the martyrs are remembered for the sacrifices they made in the service of Islam and the country. His Highness said that this is a great national occasion, as is reflected in His Majesty's statement, where the gratitude was expressed for the sacrifices of the martyrs in defense of truth, justice and the country and its sovereignty. His Highness added that this day is dedicated to honoring the martyrs who gave everything to defend the country valiantly. His Highness expressed the pride in the memory of the martyrs and of Bahrain's history, as well as that of the GCC countries, as they fight together under the banner of the Saudi-led coalition in Yemen. The representative of His Majesty the King for Charity Works and Youth Affairs, National Security Advisor and Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, affirmed that the Martyrs' Day on December the 17th is a clear evidence of the status that the martyrs hold in Bahrain and their sacrifices for their country. His Highness pointed out that the celebration of Martyrs' Day is a recognition of their status, their sacrifice for the sake of the dignity and freedom of the people of Bahrain, to honor them so they remain part of the country's honorable history. His Highness indicated that the 17th of December is a source of pride and appreciation for the sacrifices made by the kingdom's martyrs, for the sacrifices they've given their country in order to fulfill their national duty in preserving the security and stability of their country. This day will remain immortalized generation after generation to display the level of sacrifices and the extent of appreciation. He added that the Martyrs' Day is a day for the country itself, a day of repayments and an opportunity to express strong connections between the Bahraini people, who will never forget the martyrs of the nation. His Highness prayed to Allah the Almighty to rest the souls of these brave soldiers in eternal peace. The Speaker of the Representatives Council, Fawzia bint Abdullah Zainal, affirmed that the Martyrs' Day is a day for the country itself and is a day of repayment to those loyal soldiers who sacrificed their lives for their country. She noted that the martyrs of the national duty will always remain a pride and a role model for all, stressing the lessons learned from their sacrifices and remembering those who will remain part of the country's history pages. She praised the royal patronage of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa of the martyrs and their children and families, and his royal directives to celebrate the Martyrs' Day on the 17th of December of each year, and the royal directive to establish the Royal Fund for Martyrs of Duty, headed by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, to honour and acknowledge the sacrifices of the martyrs. Zainal expressed a deep appreciation and gratitude for the royal directives to celebrate the Martyrs' Day on the day that commemorates the day of His Majesty's rule, which is a high patriotic message embodying the high status of martyrs. She expressed appreciation and gratitude to the martyrs, asserting parliamentary support for their families. The Embassy of the Kingdom of Bahrain in Muscat held a ceremony on the occasion of the celebration of the Kingdoms of Bahrain on its national holidays in commemoration of the establishment of the Bahraini state during the reign of the founder Ahmed al-Fatih as an Arab Muslim country, and the anniversary of his accession to the United Nations as a full-fledged country, and the anniversary of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa's rule. The ambassador of the Kingdom of Bahrain to the Sultanate of Oman, Dr. Jama' bin Ahmed al-Kabi, delivered a speech in which he welcomed the attendees and praised with pride the achievements of Bahrain in various developmental, cultural, economic and commercial fields, noting the strong historical ties that connect Bahrain and Oman and its continuing progress at all levels. The ceremony included a variety of activities, including a documentary film about Bahrain and national songs highlighting the authentic Bahraini heritage, as well as poems. The ambassador also presented a commemorative gift to the sponsor, journalists, media workers and companies sponsoring this ceremony. The Ambassador of the Kingdom of Bahrain to the Kingdom of Morocco, Dean of the Arab Diplomatic Corps Khalid bin Salman Al Musallam, hosted a reception in Rabat celebrating Bahrain's national holidays. The ceremony was attended by the Minister of National Land Development, Construction and Housing, representing Prime Minister Saad al-Din al-Uthmani, and a number of members of the Moroccan Parliament, senior officials and Arab and foreign ambassadors, as well as a large number of political and cultural figures who congratulated Bahrain on the happy occasion. The Embassy of the Kingdom of Bahrain in Algeria held a ceremony on the occasion of the celebration of the Kingdom of Bahrain on its national holidays in the presence of the Ministers of Finance and Agriculture. The celebrations are in commemoration of the establishment of Bahraini state during the reign of the founder Ahmed al-Fatih as an Arab Muslim country, and the anniversary of its accession to the United Nations as a full-fledged country, and the anniversary of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa al-Khalifa's rule. The ceremony was accompanied by an exhibition that included a number of aspects that highlighted the heritage and civilization of the Kingdom of Bahrain, such as popular and archaeological products and sculptures and authentic Bahraini gold. And towards the end of the ceremony, commemorative gifts were distributed to the attendees. The Bahraini Consulate in Jeddah held a reception in celebration of the National Day, where the Consul Ibrahim Mohammed al-Muslimani expressed thanks and appreciation for His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa al-Khalifa, His Royal Highness Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman al-Khalifa, and His Royal Highness Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier Prince Salman bin Hamad al-Khalifa. The event was attended by staff from the Mecca branch of the Saudi Ministry of Foreign Affairs, who greeted Bahrain and wished it further progress and prosperity under the leadership of His Majesty the King. Consuls from GCC and other friendly countries were also present, as were various officials, military personnel, businessmen, members of the press, and other invitees. The audience wished Bahrain further progress and prosperity and praised its development in all fields, which made it a role model in the region. The Embassy of the Kingdom of Bahrain to the United Kingdom held a ceremony for Bahraini students in Leeds on the occasion of Bahrain's national celebrations on 16 and 17th of December. The Deputy Ambassador Advisor Hamad Wahid Sayyar pointed out that this ceremony is special as it marks the 20th anniversary of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa al-Khalifa's accession to the throne. He noted that His Majesty the King has always paved the way for Bahraini youth in all fields, praising the Bahraini students studying at British universities, affirming the Kingdom's pride in them and the high level of scientific progress they offer through their constant endeavors to expand their personal knowledge. During the ceremony, around 90 students who came from Leeds universities and neighboring cities took part in the activities of the ceremony, where some recited poems expressing their love to the kingdom, some displayed short clips of their own making in celebration of the Bahraini National Day. The embassy also honored a number of participating students for their great efforts in organizing and preparing for the events.